Ever wondered how deep we can dig into the Earth? This question has captivated us for ages. Our quest to understand our planet has driven us to explore beyond the surface, delving into its mysterious layers. We've probed the outer crust, ventured through the mantle, and aimed to uncover the deepest secrets. Our curiosity has fueled the development of innovative tools for digging into the dark, unknown depths below. Throughout numerous expeditions, each one deeper than the last, we faced challenges and made exciting discoveries. Let's dive into the history of our attempts to create the deepest hole on Earth. Hit that subscribe button and let's get started. Our story begins long ago with early humans. They started digging into the Earth, beginning a journey to the deepest parts of our world. Ancient Egyptians mined for copper in the Sinai Peninsula, while the Romans extracted gold to support their empire. People have always been curious about what's under the ground. In those times, mining was a small operation, mostly for gathering resources. The Egyptians used simple tools and their hands to get copper. They made holes and tunnels in the ground, following the metal's path. The Romans, on the other hand, changed mining a lot. They used water to wash away soil and rock to find gold. However, they couldn't dig very deep. They didn't fully understand the Earth's structure and didn't have the right technology for deep digging. Early miners faced many problems. They didn't have modern machines or a good understanding of geology. This made mining dangerous due to possible cave-ins and floods. Also, the deeper they dug, the harder it was to get fresh air. But these problems didn't stop them. Instead, they were more determined to dig deeper. These first mining attempts taught us a lot about the Earth. They proved that the Earth's outer layer is always changing, not just a big, solid piece. The tools and methods of the Egyptians and Romans might look simple now, but back then, they were big steps in learning about our planet. Even with these problems, we kept wanting to dig deeper. As we'll see in the next part of this story, this wish only got stronger over time. It led to amazing new ways to explore deep inside the Earth. When the Industrial Revolution happened, our ability to dig changed dramatically. The use of steam-powered machines in the 19th century was a big deal for digging deep into the Earth. As before, digging was hard and took a lot of time. But steam power made things move faster. These machines could do the work of many people and could dig deeper and quicker. This was a huge change that took digging to a new level. A great example of this change was the Kimberley Diamond Mine in South Africa. Found in the late 19th century, known as the Big Hole, it was one of the deepest holes dug by hand, going down nearly 1,000 feet. The mine was amazing because of its engineering and showed what people can do when they're determined. Thousands of miners worked in tough conditions, moving around 22 million tons of earth to get more than 3 tons of diamonds. The Big Hole is a big example of people's desire to find precious stones deep in the earth. The Kimberley Mine was just one of many incredible projects during the Industrial Revolution. Around the world, this period saw great advancements in engineering. New technologies allowed us to dig deeper and faster than ever. But even with these achievements, we were only starting to explore what's under the Earth. The real adventure into the depths was still ahead. During the Cold War, the United States and the Soviet Union were in a different kind of race, a race to the Earth's core. In the US, there was Project Mohol. It was named after the Mohorovicic discontinuity, which is the boundary between the Earth's crust and mantle. The goal was to drill through the Earth's crust to reach the mantle. This project started in the early 1960s near Mexico. Despite the hard task of drilling deep into the sea, the team worked hard. However, by 1966, the project had to stop because it was too expensive and had too many technical problems. Even though Project Mohol didn't reach its goal, it taught us a lot about the ocean's crust and paved the way for more sea drilling projects. Meanwhile, the Soviet Union started their own big drilling project, the Kola Super Deep Borehole, in 1970. They kept going for over 20 years, trying to get to the Earth's mantle. They faced tough challenges like very high temperatures and broken drills, but they kept going. By 1989, they had reached over 7 miles down, which is more than 12 kilometers. They didn't get to the mantle, but the Kola borehole became the deepest hole ever made by people. It gave us important information about the Earth's crust and earthquakes. The Cold War wasn't just about who was the strongest country. It was also about amazing science. the race to the center of the Earth was about learning more about our planet. We haven't reached the mantle yet, but the work done in these projects still helps geologists today. The Kola borehole is still the deepest we've ever dug. How much deeper can we drill into the Earth with the technology we have now? This question is always with us as we try to explore deeper. Today, our drilling tools are better than they've ever been. We can drill miles into the Earth's crust, and we're getting better at it all the time. We've made progress, thanks to drills with diamond tips, high-pressure water jets, and better ways to map the ground with sonar. But we're still just starting to explore. The Earth's crust can be up to 40 miles thick in some places, and below that are the mantle and the core. Drilling deeper is very hard. The deeper we go, the hotter and more pressurized it gets, which is tough for both machines and people. And there's a lot we don't know about what's down there. What if we find new kinds of rock formations or even life forms we've never seen before? It's risky, but it could also lead to big discoveries. Digging deeper into the Earth isn't just about science. It also has practical benefits. The Earth's crust has lots of valuable things like oil, gas, minerals, and precious metals. If we can figure out how to get these resources from deeper down, it could really change industries and economies everywhere. But maybe the biggest thing we could gain is knowledge. Each layer of the Earth can tell us something about its history and maybe give us hints about what will happen in the future. Digging deeper could help us understand how the Earth was formed, its climate history, and maybe even where life came from. We've made a lot of progress, but the Earth's core is still far away from us. However, with every bit we drill and every problem we solve, we get a little closer to the center of our planet and the secrets it holds. How far can we really dig into the Earth? This quest has been an exciting story of curiosity and technological progress. Starting from simple wells for water and minerals, we've gone deeper over time, driven by the Industrial Revolution and the rivalry of the Cold War. Right now, the record for the deepest hole is the Kola Super Deep Borehole in Russia, which reached over 7.5 miles down. But this is just a small part of the Earth's total depth of about 4,000 miles. Our current technology faces big challenges like extreme heat and pressure, and there's a lot we still don't know. So that's it for today. Make sure to subscribe to our channel and click the bell button to get all the latest updates.